Do any of you out there have a racket that is perfect, except it's the wrong grip size? I know this has definitely happened to me and I'm having that issue right now. So I'm Michelle and this is Troy, and we are here to talk about how to increase and decrease your grip size. Now first, let's talk about if you have too big of a grip size and you need to decrease. What would you do, Troy?
So decreasing your grip size or making the grip a bit smaller is a little more difficult, or there's less options than building it up. But a couple things that I've done, we've tried here at Tennis Warehouse, is replacing the stock grip that comes on your racket when you purchase it with a thinner replacement grip. We have a few options available. We have the Babolat Skin Fill, Prince has a Resi Thin Grip, and the Wilson Feather Thin. Those are really good options to replace your stock grip. If you wrap it really nice and tight on the handle, it'll take down your grip size a bit, maybe like a half grip size or whatnot. Another thing I've seen done, what you can do is take the replacement grip off completely and replace it with a thin over grip and just use that for your grip. That'll take the grip size down quite a bit, but the downside is it will be pretty firm, and also it'll remove quite a bit of racket from your handle, making it more head heavy.
Okay, so those are easy options to try and get that grip size smaller. Now, my problem is I have too small of a grip size and I need to build it up. So what should I do?
Yeah, so this one here is a 4 1/4. She usually plays 3/8 to 1/2. So if I was gonna build up the grip size on this one, a couple quick fixes you can do. We talked about over grip, but one over grip will give you about 1/16 of an inch. Some people will even do the two overgrips, like I've heard Djokovic does on his leather grips. And one thing you can do is put the first overgrip on with no overlap, so it's completely smooth. You won't really be able to tell it's there other than it being a little thicker. And then put the second overgrip on top of it, then having a small overlap like a typical overgrip, and that'll give you a little bit more size there. A couple more, slightly more permanent options that we do here a lot for customers. We have what we call a heat shrink sleeve. We have two sizes. We have a half size heat shrink sleeve here. This is a 1/16 inch addition to your handle. These typically weigh about 3/10 of an ounce in weight. So the white one here is the half grip size, 1/16 of an inch. And then we have the full grip size buildup. So this will take you, like on this racket, would take you from 1/4 to 4 3/8. This is a bit heavier. These are about 6/10 of an ounce, I think somewhere right around like 16 grams. So a little bit of weight to the handle, make it more head light, but it'll feel nice and firm on the handle. And then you just reapply your grip on top of that. A couple tools I use to apply the heat shrink sleeve, typically use a heat gun, as well as using a razor or an X-Acto knife to cut the trimming on the shrink sleeve. But we definitely can do that for you. If you don't feel qualified, contact our racket experts and they'll set you up, whether you're sending your racket to us or we do it when you buy the racket.
Awesome, those are easy fixes, and make sure you stay tuned. Troy will be doing a step-by-step how to install a shrink sleeve and increase your grip size video. So he will have that, and as he mentioned, if you don't feel like you can do this on your own, please give us a call. We're more than happy to help you guys increase your grip size and make sure that we get your gear perfect just for you. Now, if you wanna learn anything else about improving your game or your gear, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.